Hi, this is Jen Kepka, and I'll be talking about how to create a simple quiz using Canvas. So from your Canvas dashboard, you can see the navigation list on the left side, and I've selected the quizzes page. The quizzes page shows you all quizzes that are currently available in your course. It's also the page where we can create a new quiz. If you go to the top right, in the blue box that says plus quiz, you click on it, then you've automatically created a new quiz. There are a few things we need to fill out in this quiz before we can even get to the questions. Up at the top, we'll need to give the quiz a name. And then in this box, we include quiz instructions. This is anything that pertains to the quiz as a whole, not to specific questions. So it might be reiterating the time limit, it might be making a note of the deadline. And it's also useful here to mention any resources that students can use during the quiz. So if you have a link to an outside reading, or if they're able to use their notes, this would be a good place to put that information. Just like every other dialog box in Canvas, you can include images, videos, audio recording, anything you want to get people ready for the quiz. Now down here, in quiz type, you have four choices. Practice quizzes are quizzes that do not appear in the gradebook, even though they have a score. So students can know they got 8 out of 10 in the quiz, but it won't affect their grade. Graded quizzes clearly get graded. They go into the gradebook automatically. And then surveys. A graded survey, students will automatically get credit for taking the survey as soon as they've completed it. So it's a yes or no, did you do it or not. Ungraded survey, same idea, except it doesn't check off in the gradebook. Today I'm going to create a graded quiz because that's the beginning assessment for my Writing 120 class that deals in grammar and writing mechanics. The assignment group, you'll use this if you have defined different categories for the types of assignments in your class. Now we have some options about the presentation of the quiz. If it doesn't matter what order the answers are in, you can shuffle the answers and it will do that automatically. And here you can put in a time limit for the quiz. If you want students to be able to try the quiz more than once, you click Allow Multiple Attempts, and that brings up even more options. So you can choose whether you want the highest score, the last score, or an average of all of their scores. I'm going to choose average, and I'm going to allow them 3 tries at this quiz. The next box deals with the type of feedback students have immediately. You can see it will let them see their own answers by default. If you want to limit that so that they can only see their answers after they've tried it 3 times or 2 times or however many times you want them to try it, that's fine. Let them see their answers only once after each attempt. And this is supposed to limit it so it's less likely that students would copy their own answers down and share them. And then you can set how soon and whether students can see the correct answers to the quiz. So right now, the default is to let them see the correct answers as soon as they're done. But I could change it to be a certain date. And I could also change it so that they can only see the answers between a certain time, so say 2 or 3 days after the quiz has been taken. Show one question at a time means that a new page will open for each quiz question. And that's effective if the questions don't build on each other or if they're particularly large. Or if you want to separate questions out, so if 2 questions pertain to a certain reading and then the 3rd question doesn't, then you can put those 2 questions onto a page with that reading and the 3rd question by itself. Require an access code and filter IP addresses. These are both used if you require students to take quizzes with a proctor or in a certain campus office. So you could put in the IP addresses of your accessibility resources office so students could take it there, or an access code that only you email out to someone who's proctoring your exam. Very useful for distance education. And then down here, you can choose if there are certain groups that will take the exam or the quiz. You can fill in a due date, though you don't have to have one. You can leave them open as long as you'd like. And you can also restrict when it's available. So maybe it's only available January 1st to January 15th. All of these options will line up to make every quiz experience a little bit different. So thanks for watching this video, and I hope it's given you a better picture of how to set up a quiz in Canvas. The next video will cover how to create quiz questions.